Hello, mis amigos, and welcome back to my channel. I hope you're doing great. I hope you're having an amazing day. And today, more kitchen content, and I hope you're ready. Today's gonna be torture for me, but it's gonna be torture in the kitchen.
There's a torture in the kitchen, and it only involves me.
Yeah, I'm gonna turn this whole thing upside down. Upside down because I'm gonna be eating all the stuff that I don't like eating. I will be eating stuff that I absolutely hate for 24 hours straight. I will not eat anything else. It might result in me being hungry the entire day and hangry probably. No, actually I don't get hangry. I've searched for a couple of recipes with the three things that I absolutely hate eating. Melon, eggs and potatoes, and today we're gonna make them. Now thinking about it, technically I wanted to add tofu to that list, but I just forgot. It is a new member on that list. We're not gonna have tofu, just these three things. Let's start with breakfast. It's Past Vincent because I've already filmed it this morning, but let's see what Past Vincent will make. Bye. Good morning, everyone. The sun is out and I'm feeling okay. Hope you have a wonderful day. What does he sing? Hope you have a really good day. Wonderful, beautiful day. I don't know, I'm not Tori Kelly. This is kind of distracting. All right, so today we're gonna have a 2-for-1 special, baby, baby. Because there are two things that I don't like about this breakfast that I'm about to make. Firstly, well, it's gonna involve eggs. Yeah, that was a sad sound. Secondly, it's a savory breakfast, and I don't like savory breakfast.
All the things I hate, running through my head,
Anyway, that's not the lyrics. But for breakfast, I don't really wanna make something super fancy. I know that this is a breakfast that many people love, that Naomi loves, I think, and that's how I know this breakfast, really. So I'm gonna attempt to make the most perfect avocado egg sandwich bread toasted thingy with tomatoes. It's really easy. I don't even know if I have to film this, but I will for you guys. Before we get to the disgusting part.
Disgusting!
Exactly. We're gonna get to the good part. Also, I've got bread. I've already cut it. And we're gonna toast it. I like it crunchy. This feels like a really great avocado. Ah, it looks good. Not splendid though. Smash it. Apparently, we also like garlic in the morning because I'm gonna slice a little bit of this garlic in there. This seems like a lot of garlic. So we're gonna be stanky for the rest of the day. Salt. Pepper. I think my plan for this video is just to put tahin on everything and cover up the egg flavor and the disgusting flavor of everything. But I'm gonna put that on later because I wanna give it a proper shot. You guys like the sound? I knew you would. Here comes the part where I'm the most professional at what? It's fried egg time. I definitely know how to do it, so here goes nothing. Meanwhile, I'm gonna cut some cherry tomatoes. Ah! Ha! Cool, that's boring. Maybe I'll just prepare the bread. So it's well toasted because the toaster wouldn't stop. But I like it that way, actually, so we're good. Nice. Oh, this looks so good. I would eat this up! Putting a lot of tomatoes on it to cover up the egg flavor. Smartness Everdeen is what they call me. Oh, it smells so much like egg. Guys, breakfast is done. This is the prettier one. I don't know what this is. Ah, it's hot. That's what it is. Wow, this looks... Oh my god. Wow, this looks so good. My mouth is watering. My body is shaking. My mind is trembling. I hope that's how you feel about this. Wait, the sun. Oh, yes. Wow, so fresh. I feel like I would prefer this egg yolk, but I also really like the idea of the herbs here, so I'm gonna go for this one. Wish me luck, guys.
Why am I doing this to myself?
This is torture, but in the best way possible. Can I put this all in my mouth?
Mm-mm. Mm-hmm. More avocado.
You know what, guys? This was edible.
The reason is that I put a lot of garlic into the avocado and the bread is very flavorsome. Whenever the egg flavor came through, I felt like I had to vomit. Then I ate some more avocado and it was great. Let me try the other egg. Am I an egg eater now? Because that was all right too. It might be because I just bit on some not exactly small piece of garlic, but I didn't mind it. I feel like I'm an egg eater now. I could totally eat this all up with tahin on it. It's really good with tahin on it. Hi guys, can you believe it's lunchtime already? I just quickly wanted to add about the breakfast. I realized that I did not hate the egg as much as I used to or as much as I remembered. I did also realize that I absolutely cannot stand the smell of eggs, but the taste is bearable. That being said, let's move on to lunch. For lunch, I wanted to use another ingredient that is on my hate list, and that ingredient is watermelon. It's fall and watermelon really aren't in season anymore and I couldn't find them anywhere. Watermelon, scratch that. Then I thought, what else do I hate that comes close to watermelon? And it's actually not just watermelon, I hate all kinds of melons. So instead I bought this cantaloupe melon. I think this is a cantaloupe. I got this one and I hate it, but I will love it after lunch. So with watermelon, I wanted to make this very famous salad that everyone loves with feta and cucumber and all that kind of jazz. But we don't have watermelon, so calm down. For that reason, we're gonna make a cantaloupe salad because I still wanted to make a salad because that was the initial plan and it just didn't work out. But world, we're gonna go with it. On minimalistbaker.com, I found it's not really summer anymore, but we're still gonna make a summer tomato and cantaloupe salad. It looks very colorful. The cantaloupe here looks like peaches and that looks very tasty. I've already started cutting all of the stuff. I will continue and once it's all cut, I will be back. Before we add the melon to this, we're gonna add all of our ingredients, as in tomatoes, cucumber, onions to a bowl. These are a lot of onions. It says red onion, but I don't have a red onion and I don't taste the difference anyway, so. Now we're gonna top it off with either a little bit of olive oil or avocado oil. But since Naomi bought that one, so I'm gonna use that avocado oil. Then we're gonna add a bit of apple cider vinegar. Like, we're just gonna eyeball this. Then it says a healthy pinch of sea salt, where I'm like, you know, healthy? I don't know that when it comes to salt. And now for no reason at all, this goes into the fridge. It's actually cool already, but we're just gonna follow the recipe. Now let's make the dressing. I don't know why we need another dressing. Like, didn't we just do a dressing? But whatever. Let's put some lime juice in our dirty bowl, but we're gonna pretend it's not dirty. Now a little bit of maple syrup, some sea salt, and a little bit more avocado oil. If that's what the recipe says, then so be it. Unfortunately, now it's time for this bad boy. Let me cut her open with this small knife because I don't want to use another one. It's fine, guys. It's fine. Oh, by the way, I don't know about you guys, but what's even worse than watermelon and any melon flavor is artificial melon flavor. I actually feel like I could vomit when I smell it even. Speaking of vomit... No expert, but I feel like this melon is not super ripe yet. I think I'm gonna cut it into really small pieces so that I don't have too much in my mouth when I try it, you know? And now let's put a little bit of mint in it as well. Is this a fruit salad or is it a normal salad? Mix it all together. It is just the best of both worlds. Wow, imagine showing up with this salad to like a barbecue and everyone will hate you because everyone should hate melon. Let's put this in the fridge because we're gonna make something to drink. We need lime and technically watermelon, but we're just gonna make it with a cantaloupe melon. Then we need half a cup of water and 2 cups of ice. And we're gonna put it in the blender and that's it. Ooh, look at the pretty girl dancing. That was Tori Kelly. Again! Why is she in my video all the time? But the color is so pretty. Guys, I don't know. I must have mixed up the seasons because apparently for me it's still summer. Look at this amazing summer lunch. This looks absolutely delicious. The colors are so beautiful together. I'm obsessed. Get into the colors. This smells very limey, so that's great. Okay, I'm gonna get a piece of everything. Two pieces of melon, fine. That's a small cucumber. That really doesn't work. I like the tomatoes. The dressing is nice. How can you guys eat this? Now I gotta drink this. Lime, please be strong. I've never made a slushy before like this. Didn't know it was that easy. All right, distracting myself from sadness. That is not upon me, because only happiness is upon me after drinking this. Oh. This is very refreshing. It's very watery and limey. I cannot really taste the melon. This is great. I like this. Why do I like this? I love this. Guys, make this. Just put enough lime in it to cover up the melon flavor. All right, see you for dinner time. It's dinner time. Well, actually, it's not really dinner time. But seeing as though potatoes take forever to cook, it's dinner time, or it's dinner prep time. Yes, you heard it right. We're gonna make potatoes for dinner. I mean, I think that's the obvious choice for dinner. But we're also gonna include eggs. So we have a 2-for-1 special, baby, baby. So we're not gonna be very creative for dinner. I mean, I think I told you guys that I had to look up every recipe because I have no idea what to even do with potatoes and eggs. But I found a basic one that I think we can spice up with spices and everything to make it taste less like what it actually is. According to Tasty, we're gonna make a breakfast baked potato, but I don't know, I feel like it doesn't have to be breakfast, especially because it takes about 1.5 hours to make. So it's basically a baked potato with egg in it. I don't know, let's just get started. Let's prepare some dinner. I'm really hungry for obvious reasons. I can eat much of everything, but like I tried. Let's preheat the oven to 180 degrees Celsius and 350 Fahrenheit. In this package, I could find the biggest ones the supermarket had to offer. So I had to buy the 2.5 kilograms of potatoes, but like my friend is gonna eat them. Actually, maybe after this video, I will be a potato lover and I will eat them all up. So this recipe is... Apparently, I will now carefully pierce the potatoes with a fork. Ew, they stink. That's what they deserve. Wait, I forgot it said carefully pierce the potatoes. Now we will oil the potatoes well and sprinkle them with salt. Let's now put the potatoes into the oven for about an hour. I took the potatoes out of the oven. They are kind of cool. I now have to cut them vertically and scoop out the inside. Now we're gonna have to put a little bit of butter inside each potato. Then, please don't tell Naomi, but I stole some of her cheddar. Also, put that inside. We don't have any space in there for the egg, but it's fine. We're just gonna go for it, I guess. Ah! Oh my god. Ugh. I will put as many spices on this as I possibly can. Pepper, then we're gonna add some salt. I cut a lot of chives, which we're gonna put on it as well, like a lot. I don't even like chives that much, but you know. Italian herbs, maybe some garlic. You know what? I'm gonna put tahini on one of them because everything's better with tahini. And I think that's it. Now we have to put it in the oven. Whether or not I'm gonna like the baked potato doesn't really matter because I just know for a fact that I will still be hungry after I've eaten them or have not eaten them. But because I don't want to stay hungry, I'm gonna make another potato recipe in hopes that it will taste a little bit more like fries and I will like them that way. So that's why, again on Tasty, I found a recipe for tornado potatoes. So that's why I've got two more of these potatoes. They're the same size. We're gonna have to microwave these potatoes for 1 to 1.5 minutes, then leave them in a microwave for a few minutes to cool down and soften. Well, potatoes are cool. Now I'm nervous. We're supposed to insert a wooden skewer into the bottom of each potato and gently push it all the way through the top. I don't have a wooden skewer, but I don't think it really matters. All the way to the top. Easy peasy. We need a sharp thin knife and working in a spiral motion from one side to the other, hold a sharp thin knife at an angle and cut in the opposite direction you are turning the skewer. skewered potato, cutting all the way down to the skewer. Gently fan out each potato down the length of the skewer until you have even gaps between the slices. I mean, I don't have to be that gentle, but also, does it not go back? I think I need a wooden skewer. Because I think that way, it like sticks a little bit better. That works now. Cool, cool, cool. Let's melt some butter and put it all over this. Perfect. All right, let's prepare whatever we're gonna cover the potatoes in. For that, we apparently need 1 cup or 100 grams of Parmesan. I got vegetarian Parmesan. I don't think I need as much. I think this is about 1/2 cup of Parmesan. And now I'm just gonna eyeball this and put 1/2 teaspoon of pepper in this. 1 tablespoon of garlic powder, 1 tablespoon of paprika, and 1 teaspoon of salt. Now we're gonna garnish and cover them with our Parmesan mixture. As well as possible, put it everywhere. So for no reason whatsoever, I mean, I guess there is a reason, I just don't know the reason. We're gonna have to put it in the oven by extending it over something. Now we're gonna bake these for 25 to 30 minutes. Hello guys, I am really hungry now. The thing is, you know the thing. I mean, I can't lie, this does look great. Again, this looks pretty good. This looks very tasty. I'm gonna eat it while it's still hot. Let's eat the tornado potato first. It says to put it in the oven for about 25 minutes. It's been in there for, I'm not kidding you, 46 minutes, and it's not getting any darker, and I've given up. So here's the thing. The bottom has not darkened. The top part has darkened. The top part tastes good because it doesn't taste like potato. The bottom part tastes like soft potato and like I'm about to vomit. So we're gonna keep eating the top part. I ate it all. I'm now a potato eating beach. Yeah. So if I had kept them in the oven for another hour or 2 hours with you, then I'd probably be able to eat them all up. Oh guys, I'm so afraid. I'm gonna try the one with tahini because for obvious reasons. This is nice, this is great. This wasn't horrible. I'm an egg eating bitch, I'm a potato eating bitch. I mean, this tastes so much like tahini. When I eat that, I'm even happy whenever I taste the potato because the egg is even worse for me. But don't worry guys, I will not go to bed hungry. It's actually pretty good with tahini.
Yes, I only taste the tahini.
And we're back where we've begun this video, in my room, because the kitchen is no longer a place of safety. Even though this experience has not been as bad as I thought it would be. Yes, I'm still not a lover of potatoes, melons, or eggs, but I have found out through this video that melons actually take the spot for the worst thing ever. But eggs are a very close second place. I mean, I haven't eaten these things in years, so I was actually really curious to find out if I maybe have changed. I have not changed. I'm still the same me. Please don't hate me too much for not liking these things, even though I know many of you guys will love most of these ingredients. But that being said, thank you so much for watching this video anyway. Y entonces nos vemos la próxima vez. Y bye!